Your Excellency, the Honorable President of Sierra Leone, and also Excellency, the Honorable Vice President, and brothers and sisters, we have all joined today's distinguished gathering. I am delighted to be in your beautiful country on the first ever high-level visit from India to this country. I thank you, Excellency, President Veo, and the people of your great country for the warm welcome and hospitality extended to me and my delegation members. We are taken care, we are very comfortable that way. Both of us countries, we share a warm and friendly relation based on common values and shared vision. This relationship nurtured on the principles of justice, mutual trust, respect and understanding has grown over the years. We congratulate Sierra Leone on consolidation of democracy, which is evident by conduct of 5 peaceful elections and 3 smooth transfers of power. I bring warm greetings and felicitation from our President of Indian Republic, the Prime Minister, to the President of this great country, Sri Veo, on his election as the President of Sierra Leone last year. I am confident that under his leadership, Sierra Leone will tread the path of growth and development. I am also hopeful that our relations will grow and intensify in the coming years.
Well, my visit is first ever high-level visit. India is already engaging very closely with this beautiful country. India has played an important role in achieving peace and stability in Sierra Leone and was among the first countries to contribute troops to the United Nations mission in Sierra Leone. The deployment of 4,000 strong Indian military contingent in UNAMSIL had left a positive impact among the Sierra Leoneans. I had extensive discussion with the President today on all important aspects of our bilateral relationship as well as global and regional issues of common interest. We expressed our commitment to further build on the long-standing friendly ties between our two countries. Sierra Leone, under the leadership of President Veo, has embarked on a journey of economic reforms to realize the goal of socio-economic development and inclusive growth. In this direction, India will continue to support the efforts of the government. And today, we have agreed to enhance the cooperation on areas such as agriculture, food processing, information technology, and infrastructure development and capacity building, among others. We will also encourage Indian companies to expand their footprints in your country in the coming days. India is committed to being a reliable partner of Sierra Leone in its developmental journey. Excellency, I will assure you that we will be working along with you and we will be working together and our developmental cooperation to Sierra Leone with our lines of credit so far has been worth, as I said, 217.5 million covering a range of sectors. I'm happy that we continue to cooperate closely on capacity building, especially under our flagship ITEC programs. I'm told Your Excellency is taking more interest in education, in skill development, and in encouraging the youth to acquire these skills. I can assure you that India will extend all the required support in this regard also. And we will also work together, according to the MOU signed today, on Pan-African Tele-Education, Tele-Medicine Initiative, E-Vidya Bharati, E-Arogya Bharati. India will soon step up its efforts to set up a center of excellence in IT in Sierra Leone. India will also be dispatching 1,000 tons of rice and a goodwill gesture in the coming months. In our discussions today, we have also exchanged views on multilateral issues and to build on our existing cooperation at the United Nations Multilateral Forum. We agreed that the United Nations has to be further reflect the realities of today and address the current global challenges. We will move together. We agreed that both sides need to continue pushing for reforms so that the one-third of the mankind residing in Africa and India occupy their rightful place at the high table in decision-making bodies of the United Nations. I also thank the President Bio for Sierra Leone's support for India's candidature in various international organizations. Terrorism is one of the major challenges confronting the world. It's an enemy of humanity. It has no religion. All the nations must intensify their efforts collectively to strive to eliminate the menace of terror and also isolate nations which aid, abet and fund terrorism. India was born the brunt of cross-border terrorism over decades. I'm happy the Sierra Leone is joining the International Solar Alliance, in which India is playing a leading role in order to enable rapid deployment of solar energy globally to facilitate transfer of technology. We conveyed our satisfaction at the growing people-to-people linkages between two countries. India has extended e-visa facility to Sierra Leone nationals for ease of mobility, and both sides are also negotiating a visa waiver agreement for holders of diplomatic and official passport holders. I have reiterated India's offer to conduct a Jaipur food camp, just now I explained, as part of India's humanity program. And we also have a vibrant Indian community here, which are also believed in the bright future of Sierra Leone and stayed back with Sierra Leone even during turbulent phase of history of Sierra Leone. They continue to be organic bridge between our both nations and play an important role in strengthening of our relations. I thank His Excellency President Bio for taking care of their welfare. I am also pleased to inform that Excellency President Bio warmly welcomed India's decision to open our High Commission in this free town. Today, we have signed a number of MOUs agreements, including a line of credit agreement for $30 million for irrigation development in Tombom for self-sufficiency in rice production. India is also happy to offer line of credit for construction of a new presidential office complex in Freetown. The Freetown looks to me like a hill town. It's very beautiful. And the beauty is really very impressive. We will be extending our support for construction of a new presidential office complex. We are also reactivating $15 million line of credit for potable water project also. So I am happy today that me and my delegation have come here and had a very fruitful discussion with His Excellency, the President of a beautiful country. We have also signed a memorandum of understanding and also exchanged views on larger issues. I hope that in future we will come closer and we will have a strategic relationship to move together. I can tell you all, friends, His Excellency told me that India has to extend support like a brother. I assured him, I am making it public, that India will give a helping hand like an elder brother to Sierra Leone in the coming days. So that the aspirations of the people of Sierra Leone are met, particularly in view of the reforms that are being taken up and implemented by His Excellency, the Honorable President. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much. His Excellency the President, Honorable Vice President Naidu, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, members of the Fourth Estate, you will all agree that having heard all that have been said here today, that today is a very important day for Sierra Leone-India relationship. As a government, we look forward to strengthening that relationship and deepening our cooperation in various fields and sectors that have been covered here today through the range of agreement and memorandum of understanding that have been signed today. We want to make specific reference to the 30 million line credit to boost agriculture. You will agree with me, this is one of His Excellency the President's key objective to move this country towards food self-sufficiency. And I believe as a government that this line of credit will no doubt add momentum to His Excellency's theme to move this country to food self-sufficiency. Also make reference to the Solar Alliance Framework Agreement. Here we think that is also one area that this government appreciated cooperation. Also, it has been noted here that projects around the water supply is one key area. You know this government have been working very hard to expand water project facility, and support in that area is a welcome news. Also, His Excellency the Vice President have underlined the need for capacity building in the area of ICT cyber security. The capacity building, you will all agree with me, fits squarely into His Excellency the President's vision for human capacity development. So we want to thank the government of India, and I also want to use the opportunity to express our appreciation to the Vice President Naidu, that all these agreements and MOU signed here today signifies our president's commitment to building a fruitful and viable relationship with India. We look forward to your continued support. You have also reiterated that this is a country that is a home to generations of India, and we therefore see India as a sister country. We want to assure you and the government and the people of India that we take this relationship very seriously. We want to thank India, the people of India and the government of India, that we feel very honored with your visit. And I want to end by asking you, Mr. Vice President, and the delegation to take our good tidings and greetings to the wonderful Indian peacekeepers that serve in Sierra Leone. We remember them, we honor their sacrifice, and we want to thank them for that sacrifice. On that note, we want to wish you well, and we thank you and your delegation, and we wish you a fruitful stay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Honorable Vice President. And on that note, I still expect Mr. Kumar to take my letter with him. But we will now stand up for the national anthem of Sierra Leone. Thereafter, the President and we will all remain standing while the President and the Vice President. Excellency, we will remain seated while His Excellency the President, accompanied by the Vice President of Sierra Leone and Honorable Vice President of India, will retire for a moment, and the rest of us will go to the banquet room and get ready for lunch.